Welcome back again, hello, it's me again, Angelisa, and in this video, I'm going to react on a TikTok video from the final moments of. It is all about capturing the grace and courage in Freddie Mercury's final moments, a legacy that lives on. As a TikTok affiliate, I never seeing this kind of contents here, so most of us as a TikTok affiliate always seeing some affiliate videos or promotional videos, so that's why this is kind of like new to me that going to see this. So I will going to react this shared from a TikTok follower. But before that, if you consider subscribing me, please do subscribe and hit that notification bell for more reaction video like this. So without any further ado, it's going to react from the video Final Moments of Freddie Mercury.
In the final days of Freddie Mercury's life, the world outside his London home buzzed with speculation. But inside Garden Lodge, a somber and intimate scene unfolded. Freddie, once the vibrant and electrifying frontman of Queen, was now a shadow of his former self, his body ravaged by the effects of AIDS. The man who once commanded stadiums with his powerful voice and flamboyant presence.
He looks so thin, and it's not the Freddie that I used to see on stage or, you know, on the video.
Was now confined to his bed, surrounded by a small circle of trusted friends and loved ones. Freddie had been diagnosed with HIV in 1987, but he kept his illness a closely guarded secret, even from many of those closest to him. He continued to work with Queen, recording what would be his final albums, The Miracle and Innuendo, with a fierce determination that belied his weakening body. Music was his lifeblood, and even as his health deteriorated, Freddie's voice remained astonishingly strong, his passion undiminished. By late 1991, however, Freddie's condition had worsened significantly. He had withdrawn from public life, making only brief appearances in the music videos for These Are the Days of Our Lives and I'm Going Slightly Mad. In these, he appeared gaunt, his once robust.
Have you heard the song, These Are the Days of My Life, hon?
Yeah.
Frame reduced to frailty. Yet his spirit remained indomitable, his eyes still sparkling with the fire that had made him a star. On November 22, 1991, Freddie made a decision that would end the speculation and finally reveal the truth. He issued a statement to the press, confirming what many had long suspected. Following the enormous conjecture in the press, I wish to confirm that I have been tested HIV positive and have AIDS. I felt it correct to keep this information private to protect the privacy of those around me. However, the time has now come for my friends and fans around the world to know the truth, and I hope everyone will join with me, my doctors, and all those worldwide in the fight against this terrible disease. The next day, on November 23, 1991, Freddie's health took a rapid turn for the worse. His close friend and former partner Jim Hutton, along with his trusted assistant Peter Freestone and others who had been by his side throughout his illness, were there to comfort him. Freddie, who had always been so larger than life, was now facing the end with quiet dignity. On the evening of November 24, 1991, Freddie Mercury passed away peacefully at the age of 45. The cause of death was bronchial pneumonia, a complication of AIDS. The world mourned the loss of one of its greatest rock legends, a man who had redefined what it meant to be a performer, who had lived his life on his own terms and gone out in the same way. Freddie Mercury's death marked the end of an era, but his legacy was immortal. His music, his flamboyance, and his unmatched talent continued to inspire generations. And in those last days, as
a flower that looked a shape like, remember his the crown?
He faced his mortality. Freddie showed the same courage and grace that had defined his life, leaving behind a legacy of love, creativity, and unyielding spirit. The show, as he had always said, would go on.
Freddie Mercury is a truly a legend, and he lives on when the younger generation knows his song. He still lives on for sure. I wish this generation, the Gen Z, know about all of that you know, about Freddie Mercury or the Queen. But I just hope so that they know Queen. I have few songs of Queen's on my phone. Actually, my husband brought me two Queen concerts from Wembley Stadium, and in I think it was like a Montreal, Canada. I watch all of that. It is you know, I love watching them perform. He is so energized and a performer, really nice, and all the crowds amazing. He is truly just not just wanted to be a rock star, but wanted to be a legend, and he is always be a legend. It's nothing like about, you know, I can't compare his voice and his vocal cords into other frontmen out there. He had this really powerful voice. I can't compare that. Way powerful, and his vocal range was out of his world, and he was, you know, before his time, he will be forever be one of the greatest artists that I've ever think of, or that ever lived for me, to me. He was just like not a normal vibrant man, but also he was amazing, powerful stage presence. It's remarkable. So like knowing that he is no longer with us and we can't hear him, we just have to walk on into war, you know, and listen to Queen's music so we can remember him truly. So that's what I do when I really wanted to hear Queen. Turn on my phone or watch on TV. It's just too sad that I did not live on that era. I think my husband seen Queen on live in concert one time. When was that?
Late 70s, early 80s.
That was long time ago. Before I was born. Okay, that's not good. Okay, so here we go. Thank you so much, guys, for this one, for sending me, sharing me with this video. It was really wonderful to react on Queen and react on that video. So, well, guys, and I hope to see you next time. If you do have any other requests, send it to my messenger or my TikTok account, or just post your comments down below. And don't forget to hit that notification bell, and please consider subscribing me. See you next time. Bye.